I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making oven-baked hearts of palm spread. So we're starting with hearts of palm. This happens to be one can, which is 14 ounces of hearts of palm that's drained and then it's been chopped. And it's chopped fairly finely in about 1/4 to 1/2 inch squares. So put that in a large mixing bowl, and then we're going to add in mozzarella cheese. This is 1 cup of shredded mozzarella cheese. We'll get that in a minute. We're also adding mayonnaise. This is 3/4 cup mayonnaise. Next comes shredded Parmesan cheese, 1/2 cup. Then we have 1/4 cup sour cream. And finally, we have 2 tablespoons of chopped green onion tops. That's going to give some pretty color and some nice flavor. So we're just going to use a spatula and blend this together. And that looks great. Everything looks like it is incorporated entirely into the mixture. So now we're going to put this in a baking utensil. I've chosen a quiche dish. You could use a pie plate if you prefer. You need to spray it with cooking oil spray or just use butter and grease it or olive oil. Turn this mixture out into that pan or dish. And then spread it so that it's even. We don't have any corners here, but we want this to make a nice circular display. So we're just concentrating on keeping it even all the way around. That looks good. We're taking this to a 350 degree oven and it should bake about 20 minutes. I'll be checking ahead of time to see when it's done and I'll get it out as soon as it starts to bubble and become lightly brown on the top. Our oven-baked hearts of palm spread is done and it baked for 17 minutes at 350. And this is what it looks like. It looks delicious and the kitchen is smelling wonderful. I think it's all that cheese, the mozzarella and the Parmesan, and of course the green onions mixed with it. It's just a great smell. So I know it's going to taste good. I have my plate over here with my glass of iced tea, and I'm going to just use a serving spoon to put some of this on my plate. Now, this will be the consistency that you're going to get. It's kind of like mashed potatoes, maybe a little stiffer than that. But we'll put this over here. And what I have to go with it today, these are rye crackers, and they are Wasa brand. So you may be familiar with those. So I'm going to put one on here. And this is just garnish, because I wanted something that would spice it up a little bit in terms of looks. Now I'm going to break this in half so it's a little more manageable. And I have a little spreading knife, so I'm going to spread this. You may dip it, but it's going to be more of a spread. So we'll just spread that out. And I want to get some of everything. And I can feel the hearts of palm. They are just knots in there, little lumps that you'll encounter, but they're going to be flavored so well by the other ingredients. Let's try it. That blend of cheese is wonderful. You'll love it. I like this base too. The base is crunchy. It's a light rye flavor, but it's not overpowering in any way, so it lets the spread come to the forefront, and that's what you want in this particular recipe. It's just so good. You can use it as an appetizer for a fancy meal, a holiday meal, or you can just make it sometime when you're watching a sports event, watching TV, watching a movie. It's always good to have around. I think you'll love it.